Junius George Groves was an American farmer and entrepreneur remembered as one of the wealthiest black Americans of the 19th and early 20th centuries. Known as the potato king of the world by 1902, Groves optimized potato growth methods, outproducing anyone else in the world at the time. His colossal financial success was featured in Booker T. Washington's book, The Negro in Business. Washington's book was deployed to combat racism by providing economic opportunities for other black Americans. Junius George Groves, the son of Martin and Mary Anderson Groves, was born into slavery on April 12, 1859 in Greene County, Kentucky. After emancipation, Junius obtained a small amount of education. However, Junius ultimately taught himself to read, write, and comprehend math. With just 90 cents to his name, Junius, the exoduster, landed in Edwardsville, Kansas during the Exodus of 1879. Exoduster was a name given to black Americans who migrated from states along the Mississippi River to Kansas in the late 19th century as part of the Exoduster movement or Exodus of 1879. It was the first general migration of black people following the Civil War. As many as 40,000 Exodusters left the South to settle in Kansas, Oklahoma, and Colorado. Junius married Matilda E. Stewart a year later, and the couple had 14 children, 12 of whom survived into adulthood. After working as a sharecropper, Groves began purchasing farmland in 1884. By 1905, he had approximately 500 acres. Junius and Matilda grew the farm and business. The pair eventually built a 22-room mansion. The Groves family mansion was complete with electric lights, two telephones, and hot and cold running water in all of the bedrooms. It was the largest in the area and had its own railroad spur. I know, I can hear what you're thinking. What's a railroad spur? A railroad spur is a type of secondary track used by railroads to allow customers at a location to load and unload rail cars without interfering with other railroad operations. This is a testament to the level of produce generated by Junius Groves. Besides producing potatoes on his own farms, by the year 1900, Groves bought and shipped fruits and vegetables on a large scale throughout the United States, Mexico, and Canada. His other financial wins involved owning and operating a general goods store in Edwardsville, Kansas, while also having stock in mines and stock in Kansas banks. He also founded or co-founded the Negro Business League, the Pleasant Hill Baptist Church, the Kaw Valley Potato Association, and the Sunflower State Agricultural Association. Junius's worth was estimated at $80,000 in 1904 and $300,000 in 1915. $80,000 in 1904 would be equivalent to $2,313,222.47 in the year 2019, and $300,000 in 1915 would be equivalent to $7,643,940.59 in the year 2019, which made Junius one of the most prosperous black Americans of the late 19th and early 20th centuries. Groves mobilized his wealth and impact to contest racism. During the growing season, as many as 50 workers, both black and white, worked on his farm. He founded a Black American Community Center in Edwardsville and a golf course for black citizens, which may have been the first of its kind in the country. Groves died of a heart attack at the age of 66. His funeral, according to a local newspaper, was the largest ever in Edwardsville. He is thought to be buried in Groves Cemetery near the community center he founded. And that is the amazing history of Junius George Groves. Starting from this point forward, there will be weekly videos highlighting amazing black history. Please support this channel by subscribing, liking videos, and sharing. Soon, I will also have a Patreon page if you would like to donate to Amazing Black History as well. Thank you. I am Amazing Black History, and I approve this message.